So this is my mill. If you've watched any of the other videos on my channel, you may have noticed that there are quite a few videos about this mill. It is currently an adjustable column mill where I have 17 inches of adjustment on mill head height. It used to be a fixed column mill, and before that, it was a mill lathe combo. There is a lot of DIY going on with this mill. All this DIY is not why we are here. We are here to talk about converting your mill to a treadmill motor.
Greetings, fellow DIYer, and welcome to my video.
Now, why, you may ask, would we do that? Well, let me show you. ...200 RPM. That's my minimum. That's the slowest I can go. But because I have a treadmill motor, with the turn of a knob, fine speed control, and coarse speed control, I can go a whole lot faster. Another 180 RPMs with just the fine speed control. And significantly more with the coarse speed control. Having the ability to vary speed allows me to make adjustments on the fly. If I'm cutting something and I'm getting a whole lot of chatter, I can turn the speed up or down, depending on what the situation requires, and get out of that chatter situation. So you may be asking, why did I go with a treadmill motor instead of, say, a VFD? VFD is amazing. VFD is super accurate, it's smooth, the price of VFD is coming down, but it's still a lot more expensive than going the treadmill motor route. I got the treadmill motor for this build for free. Picked up a treadmill that someone was throwing out, scrapped the treadmill, got the motor. The power supply is built using an SCR voltage controller, and I've probably got about $60 wrapped up into that unit. Once you add some of the other stuff, you know, some of the wires, connections, we're just gonna round up. We're gonna say I have $100 into this conversion. If I'd have gone VFD, the most inexpensive ones I've found are right around $100 for just the VFD. Most of them are in the $150 to $300 range, and I would assume, as with most things, you get what you pay for. And then there's the three-phase motor. That three-phase motor is going to be anywhere from $100 to $500 and is going to require you to run this on 220. For the DIY-minded guy who is just trying to get his machine to have variable speed and to be functional for the home shop, as far as I'm concerned, the treadmill motor is the way to go. So this right here is basically the same motor that I have attached to the back of my mill. It's got an external cooling fan. It's got a nice big flywheel on it. And then it's set up with a four-wire configuration. So you've got red wire, a black wire, and two blue wires. I'm sure you may be thinking at this point, oh, getting too many wires. That's really complicated. The red and the black wires are used to power the treadmill, and the blue wires are a thermal circuit breaker, and they're super easy to wire up. I have a separate video showing exactly what you do with these blue wires. The one disadvantage to this motor is that it is a thread-on flywheel. Now, there's some workarounds for that. There's some shaft left if you unscrew this flywheel that you could use to attach a pulley. Ultimately, for this project, I decided I wanted to keep the flywheel. I wanted the rotating mass to help keep things stable as I was making cuts. So what I ended up doing was chucking my flywheel up in the lathe and turning this smooth and then boring out my pulley and pressing it over the top. And then I used a set screw just to confirm that it wasn't going to go anywhere. And that allowed me to maintain the flywheel and use a pulley system. So why is it that treadmill motors are so popular in the DIY shop? And the reason is not only are they inexpensive, they're super simple to work with. It's only a couple wires. You don't typically have start capacitors. And to vary the speed, all you have to do is vary the voltage. Now, you can do that with a pulse width modulator. You can do that with an SCR voltage controller. For a lot of guys, they're going to add a treadmill motor to this to replace the AC motor that was on there. For this project, because I removed this mill head, I no longer was able to use the motor that I had added to the combo machine. What I had to do now was come up with a way to drive this independent of the combo. And there were several ways for me to do that. When it was a standalone machine, it was really pretty simple. I used the shaft that used to go down to a conical gear and attach to the clutch mechanism in the lathe combo as a secondary pulley. So basically, I mounted a bracket off the back of the mill head and ran a belt from the treadmill motor to that secondary shaft, and then from the secondary shaft to the primary shaft here in the front. And I used it that way for probably about a year. The downside was having it be a fixed column mill. I was constantly overextending the quill, and that's why I made this an adjustable column mill. But again, different video. When I added all these parts back here, the motor had to be pushed back significantly to get it to fit and clear this tower with the linear rails inside. I also had to eliminate part of the bottom of the mill head so that I wasn't losing some of my adjustability. And in removing a bottom chunk of this mill head, I also had to remove the secondary shaft. So when I converted this, I had to add another shaft off the back to do the same type of configuration that I had with the first go round. So we have motor, secondary shaft that's now got pillow blocks for bearings, and then going to the primary shaft right here. So let's take a peek behind the curtain. So this is my current configuration. So this is the mill head spindle where moves up and down as I move the quill up and down. This pulley goes to a smaller pulley here in the back. Now we have a bigger pulley here on the bottom, and then ultimately you can kind of see it way back there goes to the drive pulley on the treadmill motor. Now what's nice about this two belt system is it allows me to utilize the RPMs of the treadmill motor. Now that treadmill motor is good for like 4,500 RPMs. So by gearing it down, you saw that I was getting between 200 and 1200 RPMs at the spindle. And that's measured from that magnet right there. So we know that that's accurate. But what's really cool about the way I have this set up is I can swap out those pulleys. So if I want more speed, all I have to do is remove this pulley, which is as simple as loosening a set screw, which is down under there, and lifting it off, and replace it with a pulley that's this size, making this a 1-to-1 ratio. Now, I'm gonna get more high-end speed. On the flip side, if I put a bigger pulley down here and or a smaller pulley here, I can slow this down even more. Now, there's not a lot of times that I would need to run the mill at less than 200 RPMs. So that's pretty unlikely. And unless I was using a really small end mill, I'm probably not gonna wanna take it above 1200 RPMs. But in the shop, you never know. You never know what kind of project is gonna come up. So it's fantastic to have that option. So this is the power supply that I built for this unit. As I said before, fine speed control, coarse speed control, master power, and then to actually turn on the treadmill motor and drive the unit. Got the RPM gauge in here. Inside this box, it's an old satellite receiver box. Again, using the DIY spirit and using what I had around, I've got everything needed to have a good quality power supply. It's not just an SCR voltage controller and bridge rectifier. It's AC chokes, it's DC chokes, it's fuses. There's lots of parts and pieces that go into this to make this a high quality setup. And I have lots of videos showing you how to put together something
like this.
So the only other thing you need to know if swapping out an AC motor to a treadmill type motor is don't just compare horsepower numbers and assume those motors are going to function the same. Horsepower is a function of RPMs. And if you have a motor that screams at 6 or 7,000 RPMs to get the same horsepower as a motor that can do it at, say, 2,000 RPMs, then there's a huge torque difference. And keep that in mind, that you have to know what the torque of your motor is to really compare apples to apples and do a swap like this. Because if you assume that just because of horsepower numbers that you're getting the same or something better, you'll be disappointed, especially at the lowest RPM. Because again, horsepower is a function of RPM. So if you are at the minimum RPM, you are at the minimum horsepower. And it's at that point that torque becomes critical. So the takeaway on all this is that a treadmill motor is the single best upgrade I have made to any of my shop tools. It's a treadmill motor upgrade that has allowed me to do all kinds of things to my lathe. It was a treadmill motor that allowed me to convert this into a standalone machine. And it's just given me a lot of flexibility. So I highly recommend a treadmill motor for anyone who is looking for a simple, budget, variable speed option for their mill.
If you like what you've seen, please click like. If you'd like to see more, please subscribe. Thanks for watching.